Hello everyone, I'm Natasha and welcome back. So today we're gonna continue our chapter 1 in that essay. So, you know, in the previous video we discussed about, you know, some practical problems on intersection and union of sets, okay? So, and in this video, you know, we're gonna do some practice questions, you know, like some few questions. So, and you know, in this question, like everything's gonna be mixed, like whatever we have discussed, you know, in the from the introduction to the, you know, practical problems on intersection and union of sets. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so the first question we have is, if set A, okay, it's actually difference of sets, you know, difference of two sets A and B. Okay, so if A minus B is equals to the elements A and B, and B negative A is equals to the elements, you know, C and D, and A intersection, so intersection of two sets A and B is equal to the elements E and F. So what do we have to find? So we have to find the value, you know, like, we have to find the, you know, like, what set, okay, so we have to find the set A is equal to what. So, okay, so these are the four options given to us, and we have to solve it through, you know, these options, okay? And last, whatever answer, you know, whatever answer we're gonna get, oh, we're just gonna take it, okay? Okay, so let's get started. So it's actually based on our, you know, our last topic that we discussed was, you know, on some practical problems. So, you know, we didn't solve any questions, but yeah, we understood something related to the, you know, practical problems on intersection and union of sets. So, in this one, intersection of two sets are given to us and their difference is given to us. So, what do we have to find? Okay. Yeah, so we have to find set B. Okay. Doesn't matter if you set A, and doesn't, yeah, we won't, you know, like, yeah, we don't need, union of these two sets, okay, we're just gonna, you know, we'll be alright with this information. So, like, I can say this is the information I have, okay? Okay, so, let's solve this question. Okay, so first of all, A minus B, so it's given all the things that are given, I'm just gonna write it once again, so the solution, okay, so given set A minus B is equal to AB, and B minus A, you know, B negative A is equal to the elements C and D, and A intersection B is equal to the elements E and F. So what do you have to find? So we have to find the, you know, set B. So set is, B is equal to, so, you know, what do we have to find is that we have, you know, we just have to find the number of elements in set B. And, you know, we have to also write those elements, okay? So, like, according to the options, we're pretty sure that there will be four elements only in set B. So let's have a look at what is it going to be. So let's use our mind and, you know, with some, you know, a little bit of knowledge about it. So, okay, so we have to find set B. So for finding set B, okay. So the first thing that we're gonna notice, oh, we're just gonna have a look at the difference of the both the sets, okay? So first thing, A minus B is equal to the elements A and B. And set B minus A is equal to the elements C and D. Okay, so for now, just let's just forget about the intersection of their sets, and so I'm like sure about it that, you know, in set A, so difference of sets in those sets which we're gonna write, so, you know, we're gonna write only those sets which are not in the another set. So this means that in a set A and B are the elements, but in set B it isn't. Got it? It isn't. So what I will say is that A minus B is equal to the elements AB. So we have, you know, this is like we have confirmed something that A and B are not going to be the elements of set B. Now let's move on to the second one we have. spin minus A is equal to the elements C and D. Okay, so C and D are, you know, okay, so let's take it in an easy way. So, just similar to the previous one. So, in C and D, so what does that mean? So, in set B, there were actually, like, some elements, like, let me say, X, Y. So, two elements were given to us already, and those are C and D. So, we have also confirmed the second thing is that the two elements are going to be C and D. Okay? Okay, so the next thing is that because, you know, like in set A, which means in set A, we didn't have elements C and D, but in set B, we had the elements C and D. So that's what we have. So the first one, so these are going to be the last two elements. Now we have to find these elements, okay? X and Y, okay? They're like undefined, okay? So, you know, just don't take it like the real elements, okay? Because, like, it isn't related to it. So, and now let's have a look at their intersection, okay? So, A intersection B is equal to the elements E and F. So, the next thing that we're going to notice is, we can notice that intersection, which means those elements which are common in both the sets we're having. Like we're having set A and B, and in which set elements E and F are actually the common. So what does that mean? So in set B we'll also have these elements, and in set A also. So which means that we've got our two elements also. X is equal to E, Y is equal to F, and that's what we have. So we have found out all the elements through this easy way. Isn't it it's really easy. So, you know, we just have to like use a little bit of mind, like right there. So, like it's all done. So what I can say is from these three equations, we get the value of, we get the, that set B is equal to the elements E, F, C, and D. EF because in intersection of sets, we can see that actually, elements E and F were actually in both the sets, which means it's going to be also in B. So we've confirmed that two elements and E and F. Now let's move on to C and D. So we have, then we noticed about the difference of both the sets. And then we also know that B minus A is equal to C and D, which means that C and D are the elements which are going to be in set B, but not in set A. So what do we have? Simple, C and D are going to be the elements. So this is how we find out all the elements in set B. So let's see if this is the option. A, B, C, D, no. E, F, C, D. It is it. So it is B option, E, F, C, D. You know, it's exactly same to it. So, set B is equal to the elements E, F, C, and D. That's it. Isn't it really easy? So, you know. Okay, so that's it. Now let's move on to our second question. So we've done our first question. So let's do it. Our second question. So stay true or false. Okay, straight true or false. Got it? So the first one we have is if A is any set, A is a subset of itself. So what does that mean? That A is a subset of set A. So actually these sets are actually the same sets. And if you haven't forgotten, like, we studied about something that if, you know, every set is a subset and a superset of itself. So, did I forget it? No, I haven't. Okay, so if A is any set, so A is a subset of set A. So what does that mean? So what I'll say is going to be the answer that's going to be true. And the reason is because every set is a subset of itself. And that's what we have. So in the question, it was given that A is a set and A is a subset of itself. So what does that mean? That this statement is true, isn't it? Okay, and the reason is that every set is a subset of itself. And yeah, every set is a subset and superset of itself. Got it? Okay, so let's move on to our second one. Okay, second one we have is given set A is equal to the elements 0, 1, and 2. Set B is equal to the... Okay, so it's like... Oh, this one is given actually in set builder form. And this one is the most commonly method used to represent a set. You know, it's roster form and this is set builder form. Okay, so first of all, we will have to find the elements, you know, what exactly, how many elements are going to be there, and, you know, which, you know, what will be those elements, like, can it be alphabet or numbers or whatever. Okay, let's just find. Okay, so it's saying, the set of all x belongs to real number. Okay, so which means that x belongs to the real numbers. Which we can say that it can be an integer, it can be a natural number, it can be a whole number, and etc. Okay, so so let's continue. So we can see one more thing that is this one is like kind of related to integrals, but we don't have to tell the integrals in it. Okay, so you know, open integral, close integral. So we discussed that if there's something is greater or equal sign will get this means that it's going to be a close integral. Close integral, isn't it? So what we can see that it here we have used smaller or equal. So zero, so it's saying that two numbers we have is zero and two. So zero, it's saying that zero is going to be smaller or equal to x, and x is going to be smaller or equal to two. So then A is equal to set B, is it? So let's find out. So it's saying either it's going to be, x is going to be equal to zero, or it is going to be greater than zero, which means it can be one. So first of all let's see that how many numbers will come between zero and two. Of course only one we have, isn't it? So so between these two numbers, one will be the second element, because we don't know the first and third. So let's find out. So it is saying that x will be equal to zero, or it's going to be greater than zero. So if it's equal, then let's write it that it is equal. So the elements of set B is actually going to be 0, 1, and 2, because in 2 we can also see that x is going to be equal to 2, or it's going to be smaller than 2. So what do we have is that it is going to be equal to 2. Okay. So if we can see that after solving it, converting into roster form, so what do we get? So we can see that set A is equal to the element 0, 1, and 2, and set B is equal to the element 0, 1, and 2. So both are common, which means they're equal sets. And that is what they're saying, that set A is equal to the element set B. Oh, sorry. Oh, no. These are the sets, actually. So set A is equal to B. So, which I'll say that this one is also true. Okay, so, I only took the two questions, but we'll do more questions later. So, in this video, that's all for today. And, in the next video, we're gonna, continue after the topic, whatever we're going to discuss is going to be related to practical problems on intersection and union of two sets. Okay, so see you in the next video. So thanks for watching and have a great day.